Let's see, born in 1925, passed away this morning. It is no doubt a great tree has fallen. That's how most people have described this, the breaking news this morning of the death of Andrew Mlangeni. Tributes continue to pour in. We're going to touch on the various aspects of his life. Very soon, we're going to speak to Dr. Mandla Mathebula. He's the author of The Backroom Boy, Andrew Mlangeni's Story. He captured, in essence, the life and the times of the late ANC stalwart, Tata Mlangeni. Dr. Mathebula joins us now live on the line. Doctor, a very good morning to you. I guess it's not that good when we lose such a caliber of such as Andrew Mlangeni. Our condolences go out to you as well and those who knew him. What would you miss the most?
Okay, good morning, and good morning to the listeners. A man of integrity has left us. There is a lot that people can learn from this icon. And the fact that he lived for 95 years with integrity, and his integrity was never shaken by his positions in politics and in society, and the hardships he experienced during the struggle and in prison, and the fact that he could not be with his family when it needed him most, he remained a man of integrity. Mm.
The book you wrote, The Backroom Boy, Andrew Mlangeni's Story. Going into this, talk to us about your approach. Did you have any preconceived ideas as you were about to embark on this, writing this book? And did that change after your interactions with Tata Mlangeni?
Yeah, well, I had my own ideas about him before I began the project to write the book. Dominant of those ideas was my perception that he is a man who hides behind the leaders. When he was released in 1989, I was still at school. Mm. And I followed the activities of all of them, including those outside the ANC who were released with him. And I was inspired by his standing locally, where he resided and where he still resided until his death at Duwe in Soweto. But after beginning the project and concluding it, I think my perception of him was confirmed. Mm. As a man who doesn't like limelight. Yeah. But another perception that I had of him was that he did not contribute much in the struggle compared to other leaders of his generation. That was proved wrong when I concluded the project, because I discovered a lot of things.
Talk to us about those discoveries. Give us some insight into what you learned about his contribution to the struggle.
Okay, first of all, I discovered that when the ANC established its military wing, Andrew Mlangeni was the first foot soldier to be recruited by the MK High Command. Mm. And the manner in which he was recruited shows that the then commander-in-chief Nelson Mandela saw something in him that many people did not see. Chief among these was his loyalty to the struggling. We all know that he was loyal until he passed away to the cause of the struggle and to servicing his people. That's why he managed to put his integrity together for the rest of his life, for 95 years for that matter. Secondly, I also discovered that when the MK wanted to train people in China, to wanted people to be highly skilled in military terms, he was one of those who were recruited or requested to form part of a group of people to be trained in China. And there were many aspects that contributed to that. For example, he never defied the struggling orders from his seniors. He was always loyal to the struggling, taking orders and executing them to the end without any element of trying to evade that responsibility. And when it comes to the relations between the SACP and the ANC, he played a role there, starting from his days in the youth wing of the youth league. The youth wing of the SACP, the Young Communist League.
Yeah.
When he was serving there with the likes of Ruth First and others, and the SACP was sort of aligning strongly with the ANC, there was some resistance from other members, especially from the ANC side. He worked day and night to make sure that members of the ANC were resistant to that integration, mm-hmm. understood that both the ANC and the SACP had a common purpose when it comes to liberation of the people of this country and fighting for freedom. And I think that part was well achieved by those like him who worked hard to make sure that it is achieved.
Such important insight into the man that was Andrew Mlangeni. Dr. Mathebula, we thank you very much indeed for coming on and giving us this insight, this perspective on Andrew Mlangeni. Be well. God bless.
Thanks.